Hello guys, Winston here. I know my second channel's been a little neglected lately, so let's see if we can't turn that around. Last year, North America was treated to the Great Solar Eclipse of 2017. I made a small project for that event, but it wasn't substantial enough to merit putting on my main channel, so the footage you just saw had been sitting on my hard drive until now. Since it's the anniversary of the eclipse, and NASA now has an exciting sun-related science mission en route to our favorite mass of incandescent gas, I thought it would be appropriate to dig up my DIY solar filter footage. Let's start with a little background. This is a telephoto lens. It concentrates and magnifies light. If you point your camera at the sun with this installed and zoomed in, you will fry your image sensor, especially if you have a mirrorless camera. There are companies that sell solar filters which are basically giant sheets of the same film you see in eclipse glasses, but these pristine panels of protective plastic are prohibitively pricey for the filthy casual photographer like myself. So I looked for a way to DIY my own solar filter. To do this, you need to know that the material you're using will attenuate light, visible and non-visible, because what you can't see can still fry your eyes or camera sensor. Mylar is one such material that does a reasonable job of blocking light. It's not perfect, and I wouldn't entrust the safety of my eyes to it, but I figured it would be good enough to keep my camera alive. To the casual observer, Mylar looks completely reflective, but it actually lets about 5-10% of normal light through. Stack up enough layers of it, and you can bring sunlight down to levels that won't kill your camera. To capture the eclipse, what I ended up doing was cutting out a bunch of rings that snugly fit on the end of my telephoto lens and glued in sheets of Mylar. I used three layers to step down light to safe levels. I used some screws to really compress the rings since Mylar is slippery stuff and I didn't trust my glue job to hold forever. Then I just stuck it on my telephoto lens and hoped for the best. One thing you'll immediately notice about Mylar is that its transmission curve isn't flat. Different parts of the light spectrum are not rejected in equal proportions. This caused the images I captured to have a bluish tint. You definitely won't win any photography awards with this filter, but you will be able to view the eclipse on your camera and even make out sunspots. I will note that for safety, I'm still not putting my naked eye behind the viewfinder. I'm either using a pair of sunglasses in conjunction with it or using live view to focus my shots. That's basically all I wanted to share, a quick little science experiment made possible by my CNC that ended up allowing me to capture close-ups of the sun during the solar eclipse. Thanks for watching, and I'll be back with more eclipse footage in 2024.